All right, even another match with the Pain Dreadful Symmetric Ascendancy deck. I'm gonna keep this hand. It's kind of like whatever, but a bunch of endless ones will be fine. I have a temple too, so it kind of smooths the draw a bit. Look a little bit of time to reflect over the deck, and maybe I'll keep some better hands this time. Okay. At the bottom. Really have to see an ascendancy here. Turn two. Good turn two ascendancy hand. Speak of the devil and they shall appear. Ooh, my opponent only has two lands. God, are we doing this? Great thing about Fan Mantugo is it's really good against red base removal. They still get the counters though, which is really funny. See, he had a double burst lighting that. That's hilarious. Fever Vision, sure. Let's just play an endless one for four. I will have all the endless ones. Attack first. I'm just keep playing endless ones because I think I can erase, honestly, anything my opponent's doing. 11. This would be 11 here. I'll have to get the 20. And even still, like, you know, the Herald is just kind of like overrun him eventually. It's not the greatest card. I mean, he can just attack me. Luckily, I have the feeder here. Attack for like 9 here. Attack for 9. I'm gonna play the spike feeder in the Fertilid to put up some defense. Kind of has the block. The next turn, if something happens to my board randomly, I can just like endless one and win 2 turns. Actually, I could just herald them and kill them too. My opponent's playing some sort of prowess deck, blue-red prowess, with fever visions. An okay-looking defense, but the herald's just gonna kill them outright. The Symmetric Ascendancy just randomly sitting here. Since they're tapped out, I'm not really worried about anything. So it's not gonna matter because I'm just overrun here. Hey, a legitimate win. A legitimate win! We did it! Right, what's the sideboard action? I like the fourth feeder here. The feeder is just a little annoying, but I think it's just like I can get around that pretty easily. I'll just kind of like one bio shift. I'll just like play the last feeder here. I think I'm good. I probably did miss a land drop or two, so that could have definitely affected something. Ooh, this is not a hand I'd like. This is a little better. A lot of lands, though. And I actually want lands if I have a Triskelion out. We'll keep that on top for now. It's probably going to get destroyed by whatever burn spell my opponent has. That's not really a great play. It's much better late game action, Scoot Mob is. Especially when we have an Ascendancy out. Spellfist? Oh, Wooden Zendikon, okay. Like it. Right, the Air Force is out and about. I need to just have two lands out for Triskelion. Do a lot of work against his Wind Zendikon. He's burned me, I like it. Not looking good. Play a 4/4. I could die easily here. Just a bunch of spell or two will just kind of kill me. Hibernation. Okay, so I'm dead to like any spell, I guess. I really wanted to see a Spike Feeder. That would have been a really good draw. Boy. I hope my opponents have any spell. Any spell just kills me here. Apparently I'm not good against Flyers. Alright. Hey, Wind Zendikon actually did some work there. Maybe we do want the clasp. I don't really like Scoot Mob that much in this matchup. It just seems like it could be really bad for me. Like, maybe I could play Naturalize. It showed me what, Wind Zendikon and like Fever Vision is probably enough for like two Naturalizes. Enough about Fog. I'm not sure if I really want the Fog. This could be okay. I could use a temple to find a third land. That's gotta go on the bottom. I have a tough keep though. But I mean, like with the scry, I think it's not that bad. Unless I just don't draw a third land here. I have a bunch of endless ones to play. Okay, kinda counts. And four now. Bottom bad guy. I can't F6 through this because I want to be able to respond if he tries to kill my feeder. Please. Guess we're just gonna have to race. The Fever Visions isn't gonna help. Well, I could just savagery this guy and start attacking, yeah. That's 14 life right here. That's a race. Yeah, we could race this for sure. Yeah, drew land. This Fever Vision isn't gonna help me out, I think. It's actually going to help me. Why not just playing like a 2/2 and an Antuco if I draw an untapped land? Perilous Voyage. I think I'm just gonna gain a bunch of life here. I'd rather just not have it in my hand. I'd rather just race. I could race with the Herald for sure. I have a lot of life. It's gonna give me like a lot of life here. Also, they don't get the Scry, which is really also important. Yeah, I'll go to 27. Next turn, I can play a 4/4. Other visions. Might get a little hairy here. Okay, I can naturalize one of these things. That's not bad. Just play the Nantuko. I'm so nutty. Seems like a not a bad shell for it. I see a lot of different decks with a few revisions, so this one seems pretty sweet. I definitely have to kill one of these. Maybe it's like kill one of these, play a 3/3. I don't really want to play a 3/3. I would rather just play 4/4s. Jeez. A lot of Fevered Visions. I can attack for 8. I'm definitely going to take some hits here. Another savagery, but I might be dead next turn. They really need an untapped land. They have to play an endless one for 3. It's kind of tough. Yeah, I think this is the only play I have. And then I have to play like. I mean, it will draw 2 extra cards, but I'm probably just dead to like any sort of burn spell. Unsummon? Jeez. What a tempo play. Okay. These things are gonna be the end of me. Because I feel like I could have actually won this game, but that was a really good unsummon. What do you. Why did he just incinerate me first? Why did he have to scry? Unless he did it on his upkeep. I don't know. Kind of an overkill there. Oh well.